Hello everyone and welcome to another tutorial video. This is the first video of a 72-part series which will take you from beginner to advanced in Linux system administration. In this series we will be using Red Hat Linux, and by the end you should be ready to take the Red Hat Certified System Administrator exam. Now before we get started, I would like to take a quick moment to give a shout out to our channel sponsor. The team over at .tech is giving us up to 90% off a 1 or 5 year domain when you use coupon code JD8 at checkout. Even better, you can get a free 1 year tech domain when you purchase any course through my website. With .tech, you can secure the domain to maximize your online brand. For example, I recently registered jtdigital.tech because the .com equivalent was already taken. If you would like to support the channel, feel free to visit get.tech to secure your domain. You can also enroll in the complete Linux administration course bundle to both extend your knowledge and get a free domain. If you enjoy the video, please subscribe and leave a like. I will upload English subtitles for each video within the series. I will also include some additional free resources in the description of this video, so be sure to take a look down there. So without further ado, let's get started.
Welcome everybody to this course. Today I would like to introduce it to you and to go over a few things such as who is the course meant for, who can attend the course, what can you expect to gain from it, and what can you expect to learn would be a better way of putting it. Anyway, this course will, I have designed it to be a two-part course. One part will be covering the very basics of Linux, Linux as an operating system. So we will cover the graphical user interface, then we will cover the terminal, basic commands there. We will dig a little bit deeper into the advanced commands as well in the first part. You will see how it is installed, how you can modify things, how you... It's the first part of the course is generally geared towards you becoming comfortable using a Linux operating system. So if you've never used it before, if you've never encountered anything of a kind before, the first part of the course will be great for you, primarily because no steps will be skipped and you will be able to learn everything from ground up. So from the very basics, and then we will move on into the advanced stuff. If you look, there are several ways of doing this, of transitioning into Linux, and I, long time ago, when I was using Windows, I have transitioned into it by using first, I don't know, virtualized system, and then I was starting to, and then I used a dual boot, and then afterwards I pretty much switched permanently to Linux. I still do have a virtual machine of Windows 8.1, but I rarely use it just for some application or for some sort of testing or something of a kind. Anyway, I will show you methods of installation, how you can install it, so you don't have to worry. Even though I have Linux installed as my main machine, don't worry about it. If you're using Windows, I will show you in great detail how you can do this in Windows, how you can install it on a virtual machine in Windows, and how you can actually install it as a dual boot. I know that a lot of the people on the net and on my previous courses have had problems installing dual boot Linux systems with Windows 8.1 and 8 due to the boot system of Windows 8 and 8.1. You don't have to worry about it. I will show it to you in great detail how to do it, so you can just follow the exact step-by-step procedure and that won't be any sort of a problem or anything of a kind. Anyway, the second part of the course is basically geared towards passing a Red Hat, getting Red Hat certification. Red Hat certifications are one of the most valued ones in the world, and they are one of the top Linux certificates that you can get. Pretty much every server administrator or something of a kind pretty much has one of those. They are not cheap, I can tell you that. They cost quite a bit of money, but they're well worth it. I mean, a lot of the people out there, when you apply for a job as a server admin or something of a kind, they will ask you, do you have any certificates or something of a kind? And if you tell them that you have a Red Hat certificate, that means a great deal. It carries a lot of weight. So the second part of the course, we will deal with more advanced stuff, but I don't want you to worry about it. If you're a beginner, I will cover all the necessary things up to that point, so you will be ready to dig into pretty much all the advanced terminal commands, and then we will get down to getting ourselves ready for that certificate, for that exam, so that you may obtain the certificate. Anyway, Red Hat certificates are taken separately from Udemy course, so you can take them at any point of time pretty much anywhere in the world. But this course that I have laid out here for you will prepare you for it, and you will be able to pass, and you should be able to pass it without any bigger problems. Anyway, there are a few things which you will require in order to follow through this course, aside from an active internet connection and the machine and the computer. I wouldn't say that you would necessarily need a Red Hat edition of Linux. I'm just talking about general stuff here. Later on, when we get into the tutorials, I will definitely make an effort to show you exactly where you can download what and how you can install each and every single one of those things. So you don't have to worry about that. For the time being, I just wanted to talk about, to tell you in general what you will need and what you should expect that you need to download or something of a kind. So you will need, you will most likely need a Red Hat image, which you can get from a Red Hat website. And it's not free, it's $50, something of a kind. The image itself is free, but the support for the image, if you wish to be if you wish to use Red Hat repositories or something of a kind, and believe me, you will need to use them, then the price is actually $50 per a year. There are other more advanced subscriptions that cost more, but this is the cheapest one that you can take, and this is honestly the one that anyone getting into anyone starting will need. You won't need anything more advanced or anything of a kind. Anyway, the second thing is that you don't necessarily need to install Red Hat. You don't necessarily need to download Red Hat. You can actually download CentOS, which is pretty much a copy of Red Hat. It's completely free, and pretty much the same commands apply, which is very nice. But you don't get the same level of support as you do with Red Hat, because on Red Hat you can log into their, you can log into your account, go to their website, and you can start an instant chat with a with their tech support, and they will resolve any Red Hat issues that you might happen to have, which is fantastic. And it doesn't really cost that much. I mean, $50 a year, that's nothing. It's actually 49, but I just circled it to 50. Also, Red Hat has a free distribution open source Fedora for desktop users. So it's completely open source, and Red Hat is open source as well, and CentOS is open source as well, but it's free of charge as well. Fedora is free of charge, so you can download it from Fedora website. That's a Red Hat maintained distro, and as I said, it's free of charge, and it's for desktop users, and that is what I use on my system today. It's not that great for servers, that's obvious. You can run servers on it fine, no problem, some people do, but any bigger work, any serious work, you're obviously not going to do on Fedora. You would do it on CentOS, which is a copy of, which is pretty much a copy of Red Hat, and Red Hat doesn't have a problem with it, because CentOS doesn't actually sell anything, they just give it out for free. Red Hat doesn't actually sell the operating system itself either, they just sell the support for it anyway. And you will be able to install CentOS, it will run without any sort of problems as well. If you don't want to pay for those $50 for the support, you can install CentOS, and the commands will be pretty much the same. There might be some slight variations, but you shouldn't worry about it that much. Although I would strongly recommend, if you are a beginner, to just go ahead and get the Red Hat edition. It's not that expensive, it's not a killer or something of a kind. It's for the whole year. Anyway, you will also need VirtualBox, a virtualizer on your Windows machines, because even though my main machine runs on Linux, I will show you in detail how to perform an installation on Windows in a virtualized environment, how to virtualize your Linux on your Windows system. I will also show you how to dual boot with Windows 8.1 as well, and how you can make this smooth transition if you're a Windows user to a Linux-based platform. There are numerous reasons for this, which we will cover in the follow-up lectures, but for the time being, these are some general things that you will need, and see if you fit into any of the groups of people that I have stated previously that could benefit, that will benefit from this particular course. Until then, I bid you all farewell, and if you are here, if you've decided to take this course, it's a huge step, and I wish you a lot of luck with it.